Good morning, children. I welcome you to the e-class of Fatima Convent Senior Secondary School. I hope all the children are doing fine and comfortable with e-classes that are being provided. Before I start, let's revise the topics being taught in the previous class. In that class, we had discussed about what is chemistry, different branches of chemistry, and why chemistry is called as central science. Now, today we are starting with the next topic, that is applications and uses of chemistry, chemists and their discoveries. Our first topic is applications and uses of chemistry. There are number of major fields where chemistry plays an important role. The first field where the role of chemistry is important, that is agriculture. Chemistry has helped agriculture in various ways by the use of chemical compounds. These chemical compounds are used to make fertilizers, insecticides, fungicides, and herbicides. Now, one by one, we will discuss the role of these chemical compounds. First is fertilizers. Fertilizers are used to improve the fertility of the soil. For example, urea, NPK fertilizers. NPK stand for nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Second one is insecticides. Insecticides are used to kill insects that destroy crops. The chemical that is used in the formation of insecticide is BHC or nicotine. After fertilizers and insecticides, fungicides and herbicides, they are also used in the field of agriculture. Fungicides, they are used to destroy fungi which destroy crops. The chemical that is used in the formation of fungicide is hexachlorobenzene. And the last one is herbicides. Herbicides are used to prevent the growth of weeds. Weeds are the unwanted plants which are found in the crops. These weeds, they destroy the crops. So the chemical that is used for the formation of herbicide, that is cimazine. Children, next application of chemistry is in food. Chemical substances play an important role in the food production and preservation. We know that smell, color can make food attractive, and chemical substances enhances the flavor of food that make food tastier. Preservatives are used to keep food safe for a longer time. The next, chemistry finds many applications in the healthcare fields. Medicines, antiseptics, and disinfectants made up of chemicals are used for curing patients. Chemistry is also used to create materials used in surgeries. Then cosmetics, petroleum, clothing, recreation, transport, communication, industries are also the major field where chemistry plays an important role. Now, our next topic is chemists and their discoveries. Here we will discuss about the scientists and their discoveries in the field of chemistry. First one is John Dalton. He was a British chemist. He discovered the atomic theory of matter. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. All matter in universe is composed of tiny particles, and these tiny particles, they are called atom. He also told about the fundamental particles like electrons, proton and neutron. Second chemist is Joseph Priestley. He discovered oxygen gas in 1775, and this oxygen gas is known as combustible gas. It helps in burning process. He also investigated some other gases like hydrogen chloride, nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and sulfur dioxide. The third one is Johannes Jacob Berzelius. He developed a system of nomenclature, which is the present system of symbols and formula. He suggested a method that helps us to write these symbols and formula of certain elements and compounds. Now, our next chemist is Antoine Lavoisier. He is known as the father of modern chemistry. He made a system that helps to name the chemical compound. For example, if I write NaCl, now this NaCl stands for sodium chloride. KCl, KCl means potassium chloride. The fifth one is William Ramsay. He won Nobel Prize for Chemistry in 1904. He discovered inert gases like argon, neon, etc. Now one question arises here. What are inert gases? Inert gases are those gases which are highly stable in nature. They are unreactive gases, but still they have certain uses. For example, argon gas, it is used for cutting and welding purposes and also used for filling electric bulb. Neon gas is used in lightning signs that are often called neon sign. Do you know, in the advertisement board, the light that is used is neon light. Sixth one is Henry Cavendish. He discovered hydrogen gas, and this hydrogen gas is known as inflammable gas. Now, why hydrogen is known as inflammable gas? Because hydrogen will not allow other substances to burn in it, but it will burn itself. Seventh chemist is Rutherford. He discovered atomic nucleus. Atomic nucleus is the central area of atom. We know that everything in the universe is composed of matter, and matter is made from the atoms. In atoms also subatomic particles are present, like protons and neutrons. In detail you will study in your higher class. The eighth chemist is Louis Pasteur. He developed the process of pasteurization. Now what is this process? In this process, the food is preserved by heating it. And by heating it, the bacteria which are present in the food, they will be killed. So in this way, we can preserve the food. Children, our next chemist is Dmitri Mendeleev. He discovered Mendeleev's periodic table, in which elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic weight. Then the 10th one is Marie Curie. She received Nobel Prize in Chemistry, and she discovered two elements, which are radium and polonium. These elements are highly reactive in nature. 11th chemist is Henri Moseley. He discovered modern periodic table. We know that there are 118 elements found in the nature. So what he did, he arranged those elements in the periodic table according to their atomic number, and he has divided those elements in certain groups and periods. So in today's class, we have learned about applications and uses of chemistry, scientists and their discoveries.